Since the 2008 credit crunch, investors have seen falls, then rises, and occasionally falls again in traditional markets. But one new alternative investment has been gaining fast: classic cars.
I think it's become very popular because many people look for an investment, and classical cars are not repeatable. It's only a limited amount of cars which are available, so you cannot reproduce them. That's why it's a very good investment for people who like to invest money, and especially now when interest is very low, stock market is very high. So if you buy a really good car, I think it's a very, very good investment.
We'll start the bidding at 125,000.
A lot of the rapid expansion in the market for cars is coming from what industry insiders call new money. With markets for fine art expensive and sewn up by generations of wealthy American and European families, classic cars offer a much more reasonable way to gain cachet. Own a Ferrari that appeared in a famous film like The Italian Job or a James Bond, it might just get you an invite to events you otherwise wouldn't attend.
We've got an industry now which is, the UK is probably in excess of £6 billion in the UK alone, and we are one, and we are, our market is relatively small compared to the USA. You've got new territories coming into the marketplace that were not here 20 years ago. We're selling cars to Mexico, we're selling cars to Argentina, Brazil, South Africa, and that's not even tapping into the new market that we've all discovered in the last few years, which is Eastern Europe.
Of course, it isn't just classic cars that are seeing this effect. Anything with a certain amount of scarcity, value and collectability, from movie posters to even motorbikes, is seeing new money rush into that marketplace. Still, for those in the know, classic cars have been a particularly successful place to be. Whether it remains so, though, may depend as much on other markets as its own performance to date. Philip Hampshire, BBC News.